Welcome to our third and final video in the series on building a home. Today we're going to talk about what happens when the home's complete. So we've talked about lots and builders and financing and selections and the stages of construction. So what happens when that home is done? So a few days prior to closing, we will do what we call a builder walkthrough. Sometimes you do it with the builder themselves, sometimes you do it with a third party company, sometimes you do that with a foreman of the company. And what this is to do is to walk through and get you familiar with the home, but it is also to create a punch list. So punch list items are those small items left before it's completely finished. So like any drywall patching or any paint touch-ups or if there's scratches in anything. Again, we're all human, so these things happen. So this usually takes place, depending on the builder, anywhere from about 10 days to a week to some builders even do just a couple days before you close. And what they do is walk around with you and create a punch list of all those items that I just previously mentioned. You'll walk around the exterior, kind of like a home inspection as far as they'll show you where your filter is, your water shut off. I will say that you are still welcome and probably would be in a good position to have a home inspector still come through. Sometimes builders miss things. You don't have to, but that still is something that you are able to do, and that's an option to you at your own cost. But while you're doing this final walkthrough, they'll be writing down and making a list. Sometimes they'll give you blue tape to put on things on the walls or things that need complete. And then a lot of them will just have you sign off on that, that was the final list that you came to with them to complete prior to closing. So as that's being done, you kind of treat it as any other home sale. You schedule your closing, you put utilities into your name as of closing date. And then we would go back through either the day prior or the morning of closing just to make sure all those items on the punch list got complete. Sometimes a representative of the builder will be there, or sometimes it's just you and your agent at that time. I will say it is common for not everything on that list to be complete prior to closing. Depending on what it is how I, as your agent, would go about advising you whether it's okay to go ahead and close or if you really should wait for that to be complete. For example, if you're building throughout the colder months and it's just too cold to lay sod, or if it's too cold to pour a driveway or your sidewalk, a lot of closing companies or attorneys will make the builder escrow for those. And what that means is they would hold back so much money and then they give them a deadline when that has to be done. So when the weather gets nice or something like that. And then once that's done, they release the money to the builder. So what that does is that guarantees that if that builder doesn't finish those major items for you, you have that money sitting there so that they could release it to you to finish those items. So I don't know if anyone remembers the Big Builder Regency when they went out of business. There were a lot of people who didn't get their homes finished or any sod because they didn't escrow back for those things. Some of the things though, you know, if there's a scratch in a floor or in an appliance, it may have to be ordered. So in that case, you're not gonna have it by closing. I just always recommend to get everything in writing, and then there's no question that they will have to do that. So once that's all done, you go to your lender and you close, you get the keys, you're a homeowner. It's awesome. You then obviously own your home, but what happens if you move in and you find some things that are wrong? Most builders have a number to call. The bigger builders have an actual warranty department. Some of the smaller builders may give you their numbers. Some may have a third-party company that you can contact. So what these are, you know, if you move in your home and you notice that something major is wrong that you didn't notice at the walkthrough, call them. And most builders are great about warranty work. Every builder, and it is state law, has a one-year builder warranty. Now that covers the major things. Most builders will also give you the numbers of all the vendors who did, you know, your furnace, your air, those kinds of things. Because it never fails, you wake up on Christmas Eve and your furnace won't work. Say they're not working, you at least have the vendor's emergency number that you can contact them. It's of course under warranty, but they just want you to have some of those numbers in emergency cases. Most of the time you're going to call the builder and go through them to get your warranty work done. Now there's different levels that different builders offer as far as follow-up. They all have the warranty, but some offer a 30-day follow-up, where they will come back after 30 days and see if there's anything wrong. But most will do a 1-year walkthrough. This typically happens around month 11, but what the 1-year walkthrough is for is builders like to let homes sit. We live in Iowa, we have four seasons most of the time, although a lot lately it's felt like two. But they like it to sit through all the seasons and go through all the movement. Your home will move. We go to extreme heat to extreme cold. So your house will contract and expand. Sometimes doors might shut a little tight. Sometimes your hardwood will separate, not hugely, but you know what I mean, as it expands and contracts. So once it's sat through seasons, they like to come back. So you may have drywall cracks. You may have nail pops popping back through the wall. And they will repair all those. Most of them will only do the drywall portion of that, and then you would be responsible to paint. Again, if there are any major issues, they will handle usually at that time. So after that's done, you just live there. You enjoy your house. I will say, if it did get sodded, you are responsible for that sod. So it must be watered. If it's hot, it must be watered a lot more than during, say, early spring, late fall. So that is our building series, kind of from start to finish. If you ever have any questions or want to investigate a little further about what it would entail to build a home, please reach out to me. I love new construction. I grew up kind of in the construction world. I've been in new construction for 15 years, and it is just so much fun to watch something go from a vision to completion. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to call me, 515-210-1021. Have a great day.